The brain is a very complex organ, and it's difficult to find a safe corridor to access it. So neuromonitoring is a way that we can electronically record from and stimulate the brain and help determine what is the safest corridor to access, say, a tumor or an AVM or vascular malformation. So it's a safe way to approach lesions through a very delicate structure with no obvious roadmap to it. Specifically, this is called cortical mapping. Cortical mapping is a form of brain mapping that allows you to, once again, you can stimulate the brain, take recordings from the extremities, but you can also record directly from the brain and determine where the very sensitive areas are. For example, the primary motor cortex and the somatosensory cortex are areas that you cannot violate when you're taking something out. So whether a tumor is next to or below these areas, it's good to know what that relationship is. We use it now as a safety measure. We do it while people are awake. So once we've done the craniotomy and we're looking at the brain surface, we're trying to determine how we can access lesions that are near or beneath that surface. So the patient is not awake, they're asleep, but we are taking recordings and stimulating and finding points of access. So this is different than spinal surgery in that it's much more refined. In spinal surgery, we use these recordings to determine our proximity to nerve structures. So anything that's delicate, the spinal cord, the nerves, we can detect how near or far we are from the instrumentation. Certainly if you're pinching a nerve, you'd want to know that while you are doing surgery. So it's a form of live feedback, it's continuous feedback. And unlike imaging, which has to be done sporadically, this is, it's seamless and it's real time.